Hey guys, a very good morning to all of you. So NABARD grade A examination is over now. I hope that you all have performed well and the result will come out in your favor only. So this is the video for current affairs that will help you in your phase 1 of RBI, SEBI, and NABARD is already over, so I cannot repeat myself here. But the students who are going to prepare for the next year's NABARD, they should definitely watch this video because this will develop the understanding of the affairs, of the issues that are going on in the country as well as in the world at present. And once you have the basic understanding developed around the affairs that are going on in the world and in India, then obviously you will be able to memorize the facts better later on when the exam notification comes out. Because you know that only 6 months exam current affairs are important for any examination, but I must say that regulatory examinations tend to go beyond 6 months as well. So if you are appearing for the next year's NABARD, then this video will also be beneficial for you. But for the RBI and SEBI students, this video is definitely useful for you guys because expected hai ki SEBI and NABARD examinations bhi is saal ke year tak, is saal ke end tak aur agli saal ki beginning tak announce ho jayenge. Okay, but remember, this is expected. Don't ask me for the notification because I'm saying that expected hai ki aa jayenge. So this is your responsibility to start preparing for such examinations if you aim to become a grade B officer in RBI or a grade A officer in SEBI. On that note, let's begin our video, which will be catering to your phase 1 GK. Okay? So guys, the very first question that we have here is, how many people will be forced to migrate from their countries due to the climate change by 2050 across all regions as per the World Bank's Groundswell Part 2, Acting on Internal Climate Migration Report? So you have so many numbers in the options, out of which the right answer is option A, 216 million people will be forced to migrate due to the climate change. Now, the very first thing that I want to state about this report is that this is not a very important report because here are not many facts that can be of use in your examination are stated. The main fact that can be asked either in your phase 1 or phase 2 ESI is this statement that as per this report, 216 million people will be forced to move out of their country because of the impact of the climate change. And this is highlighting the pressuring need for action to tackle the climate change. Now, you can also, if you remember this statement well, you can also cite it in one of your descriptive answers if any question comes on climate change or Paris Agreement or treaties related to climate change and environment, because climate change is becoming one of the hot topics of today and the pressing issues of our times. Now, this is the second edition of this report. The first edition of this report was released in 2018 only. So do remember this as well. Moving on to the next question. Who among the following from India has featured in the Times 100 Most Influential People 2021 list in the category of Pioneers list? So let me tell you that this Times 100 Most Influential list has a number of categories and the number is 6. So in a total of 6 categories, the people, top 100 most influential people are mentioned. And from India, Adar Poonawalla, who is the CEO of Serum Institute of India, has featured in the Pioneers list. Now let's have a look at the other people who are featured in this list from India. Okay, so the very first and the most prominent name in this year's 100 Most Influential People's list of Times is Prime Minister Narendra Modi, who has featured in the Leaders category. And you must know that the description of PM Modi mentions that after Jawaharlal Nehru and Indira Gandhi, he is the third political leader who has impacted Indian politics as it has never been done before him by any other leader except for Jawaharlal Nehru and Indira Gandhi. Okay, that was just an additional info, nothing to do with your examination. But do remember, Prime Minister Narendra Modi and West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee both have featured from India in the leaders category. Yaad rahega, because both of them are the leaders. Next is Adar Poonawalla. So he has featured in the pioneers list. And the fourth person is Manjusha P. Kulkarni, who is the executive director of Asian Pacific Policy and Planning Council, and she has featured in the icon list. So these two are the other names. So in total, four Indians have featured in this Times 100 Most Influential People's list. Now, as I mentioned, that the list is prepared across six dimensions or six categories, and all of these six categories have a leader, or we can say have a person which ranks at the top in these categories. So let's have a look at them. So icons category is topped by Prince Harry and Meghan Markle, the Duke and Duchess of Sussex. Then pioneers category is topped by Billie Eilish. Titans is by Simone Biles, who is the American gymnast. Artist is Kate Winslet. Leaders, Ngozi Okonjo-Iweala, who is the first female director general of WTO. Innovators, Jensen Huang. So these are the leaders in all of these categories of this Times 100 Most Influential People's list. Moving on to the next question. Which state has signed an MOU with UAE-based DP World, a leading port and terminal operator in the world, for investment of Rs 2000 crores in the state? Okay, let me tell you why this question is here. The basic reason is the prominence of the DP World. It is the world's leading company in the field of ports and terminal containers. That's why it is in the news. So recently, the state which has signed an MOU with this company is Tamil Nadu. Okay, so Tamil Nadu and this DP World, both of them have collaborated for this. Both of them have signed an MOU for investment of Rs 2000 crores in the state for developing different kinds of projects related to the terminal containers and ports. And here is the list of projects that will be developed by DP World in partnership with the Tamil Nadu government. Okay, now this point is not very important. You don't have to mug this up, because this will not be asked in any of your examination at any stage. This is just for the additional information, because you have a lot of MOUs. So when it comes to MOUs, if you identify the uniqueness of the MOU, it will help you in memorizing them better. Okay, because India or states or companies, the Indian organizations, the departments of the government tend to sign a lot of MOUs. So here, the reason and the unique point of the MOU will help you in grabbing the information and retaining it for good. Next question is the question which we will be discussing after we discuss the news. So here we are going to adopt a different approach. Okay, I have just hidden the answer. I hope that you, majority of you, haven't seen the answer. Otherwise, the purpose is defeated. Okay, so this echoes, or what you can say. AUKUS. So this is a trilateral security dialogue, trilateral security partnership, which has been set up by the prime ministers of UK, who is Boris Johnson, US Joe Biden, Australia Scott Morrison. Okay, so all of these leaders have established this partnership. If you see the name of this partnership, clearly you can identify the names of the country. A stands for Australia, then UK, then US. Okay, so from here you can memorize the countries involved in this partnership. Now, the other main point that you need to know is that this partnership has been established just a week before the leaders summit of Quad grouping. Okay, now what is the reason of establishing this partnership? The reason is to counter the China's expansionist policy in the Indo-Pacific region by deepening the security, politically, diplomatic, security and defense cooperation among all these three countries. Okay, Now, how will they achieve this thing? How will they stop China from expanding in the Indo-Pacific region? And if you are a bit knowledgeable in the geopolitics, then you would know that China and Australia share a bitter relationship in the geopolitical arena. Okay, so under this partnership, basically UK and US will help Australia in developing nuclear submarines. Okay, and those nuclear weapon submarines will be developed inside Australia only with the help of UK and US. So this is how this partnership will work. Okay, the place is this. Adelaide in Australia, this is the place where the manufacturing of nuclear missile submarines will take place under this partnership. Okay, I hope that you have understood this partnership well. Now let's have a look at the question, what the question is about from this news. Recently, AUK, US, or if we want to pronounce it, AUKUS, led by US PM Joe Biden has been launched. Which of the following statements is clearly stating the objective of the grouping? So what do you think, guys, is the right answer here? Let me read out the statements. It facilitates development of nuclear powered submarines by Australia. UK and US will provide technical assistance to Australia. UK will have an influential role in the Indo-Pacific by virtue of this partnership. The partnership will counter China in the Indo-Pacific region, or all of the above. Now, I guarantee that majority of the viewers who are watching me right now would think that option E is the right answer. But my friends, you are wrong here, because option D is the right answer. Read the question carefully. It is asking you about the statement which is clearly indicating the purpose of this partnership. Okay. It is not asking you that which statement is correct about this partnership. It is asking you about the correct purpose, the statement which clearly gives out the purpose of this partnership. So the clear purpose is to counter China in the Indo-Pacific region. And how are they countering? By deepening their security, diplomatic and economic ties in the among themselves, and providing nuclear submarines to Australia. So this is the statement, or this is the partnership all about. I hope that you have understood it well. And here again, I would like to say that you have to read the questions carefully. Moving on to the next question, which has become the first private company to sign an MOU with National Small Industries Corporation for reviving MSMEs which are affected by COVID. Okay. So here we have five options, out of which option D, Arcelor Mittal Nippon Steel India, is the right answer. Now guys, why is this in the news? The reason behind this is that this is the first private MOU. This is the first MOU that NSIC has signed with a private company, and that company is Arcelor Mittal Nippon India Limited. Okay. The next thing about this MOU is that via this MOU, by virtue of this MOU, the supply of steel to the MSMEs will be made easier so that they can recover better. So here no kind of subsidy or no kind of benefit will be given to MSMEs, but the help in providing them the steel raw material or any other kind of material related to steel, by easing out the distribution supply chain for steel. By doing that, they will be helping the MSMEs in reviving their own businesses, and thus revive overall the MSMEs which are affected by the COVID-19 pandemic. I hope that you have understood it. Moving on to the next question, which is the venue of the 19th Asian Games 2020, which will be, 2022. So this 19th Asian Games will take place in 2022 in option E, Hangzhou, China. So this is a city in China. Now guys, all these statements that are mentioned here are just for your information purposes, except for the first statement, that is the venue of this championship or this games. The next point here is that Olympic Council of Asia will be organizing the Asian Games, the 19th edition of Asian Games. The most unique point I would say that I found the most interesting here is that e-sports. Digital sports have been introduced in this edition, in this championship. So that is something that I found very interesting, and I mentioned here it particularly because this is a new, I would say, a new development in the field of sports, where the digital sports are also getting involved in the formal official international tournaments like the Asian Games. Okay, so that was interesting point. The next point that is of importance is this. The Asian Electronic Sports Federation will be the technical partner of this OCA, Olympic Council of Asia, in organizing the e-sports during the 19th Asian Games. Okay. On which of the following social media channel has Union Information and Broadcasting Ministry launched its account with the name of PIB Fact Check? So the very first fact that you should be aware of is that PIB belongs to Ministry of Information and Broadcasting. Okay, now PIB Fact Check is the channel that has been recently opened on Telegram. Okay, so option A is the right answer. Guys, information like these tend to basically they appear very uninfluential. They appear very normal and not important, but they can become a question. Therefore, you have to keep your mindset open and read and memorize such kind of news. And we are here to help you in that only. So recently, Union Information and Broadcasting Ministry has launched this PIB fact check, check on the Telegram channel, on the Telegram application basically. The basic purpose is to identify or verify the information related to center and disseminate to its subscribers, okay? Verified information, the basic purpose is to spread the authentic information to the users, to the subscribers of this Telegram channel. Okay. This is the only central government fact checking platform that is there, that is launched by the central government. Okay. So do remember this as well. So guys, that was all for today. I hope that you have enjoyed the video, and if you have, then do not forget to share it among your friends who are preparing for RBI, SEBI, NABARD or any kind of banking examination at the level of PO. And subscribe kar do if you like the video. Thank you so much.